ago tag. So I feel like going into 2018, I should be just a tad bit a little more personal with you guys, not extremely personal, but I feel like y'all see enough of my real life in vlogs day to day. So I just wanted to do this tag. I feel like it was a cool way to end out the year. I actually had wrote everything out on my iPhone and then I forgot. I'm using my iPhone to record until I can get a memory card from my camera. So yeah, so guys, just excuse me today. I'm all over the place. I found I have to purchase a new laptop. My laptop is done. The battery is done. It won't work unless it's plugged into the thing. So I'm just trying to figure out how I'm going to get the rest of these videos up. But like I said, I'm going to finish Tokyo the Slay. I'm not giving up. So yeah, let's just jump right into it. So the first question is, what is your biggest accomplishment of 2017? So I said that my biggest accomplishment of 2017 was basically conquering like depression and anxiety. And I know people get sick of hearing YouTubers always talking about how we're depressed or we have anxiety, but honestly, people don't really understand that we're YouTubers, but we're humans too. Like, I am a full-time student and I work a part-time job. So my brain is constantly all over the freaking place. It's not like just one-sided where I'm just doing one thing. Like, I'm doing multiple things, trying to find multiple ways of input. And what's all I have to say? Yeah, like y'all already know. Like, when I was in school away from home, that's when it really hit me. I never realized, like, maybe I had it. I think I had it maybe most of my life, but it never hit me until I left for school. So it's just like, so that's that. And one of my other biggest accomplishments of 2018. See, I'm just ready for 2018. I've been over 2017.
No, I'm ready for 2018.
That's right, Mom. Tell her.
Win the lottery.
I hope she really does win the lottery, because she talks about winning the lottery every day.
And I hope I go on Family Feud for my 43rd birthday.
Nobody's taking any of them. Anyway, another one of my big accomplishments of 2017, I feel like, was building my brand up. I feel like I had to, I don't know, like, I'm not burning anything. I went through a little something over the summer and it literally lit a fire under my ass. And it made me just want to focus on building my brand up. And I'm glad that it kind of happened, because if it didn't happen, then I just would have, I don't know, I would have became very lackluster, you know? So it says, the second question is the best memory of 2017. So my best memory of 2017 is that I am finally officially done and I have my associate's degree. I just have to pay everything off and get it. I passed my math class. I thought I wasn't gonna pass. I just kept saying to my mom, as long as I pass with a C or a B. And I came out with a B and I was surprised. But anywho, I'm just happy to be done. Like, I never have to go back to that school except for to pay them. That's it. It's over. Like, that is the best memory. That's the best memory of life. Because going through community college was the biggest struggle ever. Yes. What is the biggest obstacle of 2017? So y'all know how I just said I had a fire lit under my ass if something happened? So I said that. I don't want to say that I got my heart broken. I don't know what to call it. Yeah, I put overcome and heartbreak. And like I said, like, honestly, with that, or I don't even think it's a heartbreak. Just that things weren't working out. And I don't know how to explain. Like, I put overcome and heartbreak in here. But I don't even necessarily can say it's heartbreak. I think it's just like realizing that sometimes you can't give your all to a person and that makes you want to do better for yourself. If that makes any sense. I don't think that's, I'm putting it the right way, but I understand it. Hopefully you guys understand. Okay, so the next question is really the top five, my top five favorite beauty products of 2017, but I had to add a sixth one in there because there was no way in hell it was five of them. So my first top five is the Juvia's Place Magic Palette. It's actually sitting, it's right here next to me. I actually used that to create this look today. I freaking love Juvia's Place's eyeshadow palettes. They are the most freaking pigmented eyeshadow palettes. Like, you honestly don't even need an eyeshadow primer to go on with the freaking palette. Like, you just put it on and it will be pigmented as hell. I love their eyeshadow palettes. I'm so waiting for this festival eyeshadow palette to drop. I only have the Magic palette and the Zulu palette. I didn't want any of the other ones. I didn't want the Masquerade. I didn't want the Saharan, the Saharan one or two. I didn't want the Nubia one or two. So yeah, that was my favorite. Another favorite of mine, as you guys know, is a holy grail product, the Wet n Wild setting spray. Now, the one I use is the Natural Finish. They just dropped a matte finish one. I have yet to try it, but I don't even think I want to try it because I just love the way that the Natural Finish just sets my freaking makeup. And that shit is like, it's makeup holy water. It's like, you know, like what Fix Plus is to people? What Fix Plus is to people is what this Wet n Wild setting spray is to me. Like, I can't even really truly tell y'all. Like, anybody, I always tell them to get the Wet n Wild setting spray. Like, anybody. And I think I put too many people on because now Walmart don't be having it. But it's okay because they know how good it is. At least I ain't the only one who knows. So Wet n Wild, y'all did that. Y'all really did that one. For real, for them. The next one is the Real Techniques Miracle Body and Complexion Sponge. Okay, so if it wasn't for Ashley D Beauty, I would have never freaking known about this thing. And so I just love the way that it blended out her foundation, and I had to go pick me up one. I should probably buy another, but that's also over here. Like, most of my favorite products are really on the side of me, like, because I just did this makeup tutorial. But it's just like, if you don't own one of those sponges, you need to get them. It is way better than a beauty blender. The Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge, period, are better than a freaking beauty blender. And I know that they typically say you're supposed to use your beauty blenders or sponges wet. I don't use mine wet. I don't put water in it. I actually just spray my setting spray and blend it out like that. And Lord knows I can't even tell y'all like the life it gives me. Okay, the fourth product is Velvet Teddy from MAC. I got it for my birthday and I didn't realize how freaking much I would fall in love with that lipstick. I'm damn near out of it, so I have to, like, I'm gonna have to get another one. I've been trying to not use it so much and, like, find my other, like, nudie pink lipsticks, but I freaking love Velvet Teddy. That thing is life. I don't know why I waited so long to get it. Like, that should have been one of the first MAC lipsticks I ever purchased, but Velvet Teddy is it. It's it. I swear to God. Okay. The fifth one is the Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector in Opal. I don't even gotta tell y'all because y'all already know. You know I got everyone today. I freaking love this stuff. I just want to say thank you, Falange. My friend Falange got it for my birthday. I never tried any of Becca's products before until she got me that highlighter. And that shit is past everything. Like, I'm just speechless. Like, I really am. My sixth favorite beauty product of 2017 is the Morphe 35B palette. I don't know if I ever told y'all this, but okay, so it was after spring break and a girl at the dorms was selling the palette. She worked for Ricky's. As you guys know, I formerly worked for Ricky's in October of 2016. I hope to get the job back when I move to New York permanently. Like, I really love that job. I love that company. And I freaking love Ricky's. Anywho, so she worked for Ricky's. And Ricky's is the only place besides the actual Morphe stores that sell Morphe palettes in store. Otherwise, Morphe is online or located in California. Anywho, she sold me this 35B palette for $12. Morphe palettes run from $20 to $40 now. Yeah, they upped the prices a little bit. And it was the best $12 investment I ever made in my life. Anytime I do colorful eyeshadow, I use this palette. I like totally have disregarded my BH Cosmetics Moderate Mattes. This is the only one I use, these two, like this freaking, it's right here. This fucking Morphe palette is life. Like, if you don't have the 35B, I don't care if you don't like colorful eyeshadow, you need to get it. Like, press order now, sis. Get that now, sis. Like, yes. Okay, so the next one is some bloopers for 2016. I'm probably just going to post some Snapchat clips. Y'all can get a kick out of that, because that's where all the bloopers happen, okay, on Snap.
Looking at the phone, it's no name in sight. Block dot D, knew something just wasn't right. Yamalis becomes a sandwich table. Money. Yamalis.
Yeah, I'm pretty, but I'm local. Tell how y'all be moving so low. Ain't no treaty where the hoes go. Ayo.
It's good.
Hey. Hey.
It's lemon.
Hey.
20,000 ones. She said, I'm that nigga.
Hey, baby.
I love them.
I thought it was a picture.
Semi-drunk. Right, when me and Sabrina been friends forever. And since we never posted since pre-K.
Did you know the shit?
They never happened in the actual recording. So, yeah. Okay, so the next question is favorite mainstream and non-mainstream YouTubers. I have a whole list of YouTubers. I don't watch TV out, really. I only watch Netflix and YouTube. So, I have plenty of time to find new YouTubers. So I'm just gonna run down the list, and some of these people y'all already know I love. So, Jayla Corian, top fave. Our life is literally identical. Like, and watching her really inspired me to wanna move back to New York, because she followed her dreams, and living in New York has always been my dream, and I really was about to give up on my dream. But that's why I decided to go back to school and everything, and just work and change my major and work towards everything I want and not give up, because I feel like, not that I have a lot to prove, but her life is just my life. It's just so weird. Like, I be watching her vlogs and I just be like, wow, our lives are just like very similar. I love Raven Elise. Y'all know that I love Raven Elise. I love little Zaya. Like, she is so cute. Ashley D. Beauty or Ashley Devonna. I freaking love Ashley. And oh my God, Ashley retweeted me this year. Like, what? Like, yo, I almost had a heart attack. I think Raven retweeted me too. I know Jackie Aina has freaking retweeted me a couple freaking times. Like, Jesus Christ. I love them. Dana Alexia. I just discovered her a few months ago, but she is so beautiful. She's from Canada. She is bomb. Like, she is like one of the most poppinest black girls I ever seen. Go boo. She is so cute. As y'all know, I love the Notorious Kia. Like, style super on point, and like her the vintage stuff she finds, like, it's like, okay. Jerry the Worst. I don't know if you guys know about her, but her freaking makeup, like, okay, she inspires me because, like, as you guys know, I don't think I'm a makeup artist. I would call myself a makeup enthusiast. Like, I really don't want to do other people's makeup. I just enjoy creating, just to be creative. And I feel like she does the same. And even if her makeup isn't perfect, she still freaking posts it. And that's inspiring and make me just realize, like, yo, like, no matter what, go hard. And I just want to shout out to my friend Lola May too, because like, I just put this look on Snapchat and I haven't been trying to like debut any of my looks I'm doing for 12 days to say, but Lola was like, apply the pressure and go hard. Like, the last two looks I did, like, I just went hard, so I had to continue. And like, I feel like that's what Jerry the Worst does, and like, she's just so dope. Like, I really like her. Brianna Marie, of course. I shouldn't even have to talk about Brianna Marie. Y'all know she slays. Everything she slays, she slays. Oh my God. Oh my God. Like, there's nothing else to say. Anaya Rodriguez or The Annihilator. I just love her. I've been following her on Instagram for a long time. I always thought she was mad pretty. Her style is super dope. And I'm so glad she made a YouTube channel, because she's just bomb. And like, she's so inspiring too, because she has her own business. And like, it's just so cool seeing everybody like on YouTube that's like around the same age as me, like, just doing a damn thing. I love it. I love it. I love it. Vicky Logan. Y'all know I just love the entire YouTube sisterhood. Like, I love them all. Like, I freaking love them. The Glam Twins. I can watch the Glam Twins all day. I love Kelsey and Kendra. They are freaking bomb. And oh my God, their hair. I hope that my natural hair can be as long as that one day. Like, they are freaking bomb and they're so dope. Lakia Starr. Lakia Starr. I just love her. I love Sarai. I freaking loved her since she was on Instagram just doing tutorials. So yes, Karen, just come to YouTube and just slay us through. Makeup Shayla. Y'all know I love Makeup Shayla. I love Makeup Shayla, and Maj put me on to Makeup Shayla. If it wasn't for Maj, I would have never known about Makeup Shayla. I freaking love Makeup Shayla, and I love Amrezy. And yes, I just, Makeup Shayla just slays my life all the time. Anywho, the next person on my list, Alyssa Ashley. I freaking love Alyssa Ashley. Oh my God, and I love when she does Mystery Makeup Mondays. Like, yeah, who would ever thought of that freaking idea? Like, that is so freaking different. Y'all know I love Aaliyah J. I met Aaliyah J. She's really sweet in person. Like, she's so tiny and so cute, and I just love her content. I love Armand and Trey. Like, they could drop a singing video today and I would just watch it. Like, I so be fangirling off of Armand and Trey. Like, y'all don't even know. Daisy Marquez, she slays. She's mad pretty and like, oh my gosh, she's so dope. I'm so mad I didn't get to meet her at BeautyCon. She definitely was there. Like, I don't think I was watching her videos so much then. So yeah. Lanye Maiden, makeup by Lan Yeezy. Oh my God. Yo, so every time she posts this tutorial, anything, I just go and watch. Like, and she replied to my comment like 2 weeks ago. That is so freaking dope. Glow Princess, like, yes. Can we talk about Melanin and just popping? Like, freaking love Glow Princess. Malibu Dollface. Y'all shouldn't even, we're not even gonna speak on Malibu Dollface because y'all know he slays. He fucking slays everything. Anything you give him, he gonna slay it. Next one, Melly Sanchez or The Fashion Freak. I just love her makeup tutorials. I love how she dresses on Instagram and she's just popping. Makeup by Griselda. Woo! She's a baddie too. I love Makeup by Griselda. Nikki tutorials, y'all know anything she touch, she slays. Like, there's no freaking way. Like, I love Nikki tutorials. Ofra Zenfali, I think I said that right, but I just love how, like, she's so popular. She got the piercing in her lip, and she's just a thick, bad girl. Like, I love it. I love it. Passion Jones, yeah, she is, like, the plus size Barbie. Like, I freaking love her. Like, she is so popping. She's bomb. Okay, I also love Sharlena Nim. If you guys don't know who Sharlena Nim is, you need to follow her on Instagram. She was popping before YouTube, so make sure y'all follow Sharlena Nim. Like, just her outfits, her sneaker collection, like, oh my god, like, I love her. I love Tierra Walker. Oh my god, like, Tierra is so popping. Like, and she got a bob right now, and she just slaying through with this bob. I'm just like, yes sis, give me all the life I need. And last but not least, you know I had to put my girl on this list, Time the Infamous. I love her forever, love her. I've been watching her since I've been on watching YouTube. I freaking love Time the Infamous. Okay, so your regrets of 2017. Like I said, one of the biggest regrets I have of 2017 is almost giving up and moving from New York. And when I was in New York, not spending as much time in New York and getting to know my surroundings and just coming home a lot, I feel like I should have, even when I wanted to come home those weekends, I should have forced myself to stay, money or not, and just explore. I feel like I would know a lot more about New York if I would have did that. But it's okay, because I feel like with moving there, hopefully by August or September, I can make up for the lost time or the lost things I missed out on. And so yeah, I'm like excited. What the hell? The most memorable phrases of 2017. I only had 3 phrases I said, and I say this on a daily basis. And the first one is, oh no, that's canceled. Like, that means it's not happening, it's not going down, don't think about it, don't try it, sis. Don't try it. And as y'all can see, I say sis a lot. I've been saying sis, like, no sis, just don't try it sis, like, okay sis. That really be me. And Shaq Coins, everybody knows, get your money. You know, all about Shaq Coins. Like, how I'm just about to disappear for like 2 weeks with these holidays because I'm beginning these Shaq Coins at work. Okay, hunty. All right. So, what is your most embarrassing moment of 2017? So, my personal most embarrassing moment is when I cried because my $40 damn balloons flew out on the goddamn highway on my birthday. I was so pissed. Like, I didn't even get to enjoy my balloons for a good couple. I only got to enjoy it for a good couple hours. Actually, let's bring that up. Just kind of pissed me off again about the damn balloons. Okay, moving right along. What are lessons you learned in 2017? Definitely a reinforcement of dreams don't work unless you work. Like, if you don't go hard after what you want, it's not gonna come easy to you. And like I said, at a point in time, I had a fire lit under my ass, and that just made me want to go hard for everything I wanted to do. I almost gave up with school, and I wasn't gonna go back. Actually, I was gonna transfer if they didn't switch my major, but everything happened and they switched my major. I'm enrolled back. I'll be starting January 16th. I'm really excited. So yeah, another lesson I learned is don't let nobody step foot in front of your tunnel vision. If you got a goal or your eye on a prize, keep your eye on that. Don't let nobody in your way, no matter what. Don't let nobody tell you that you can't do something, because the same people that's telling you that you can't do something is the same reason why they asses ain't end up doing something. Just think about it like that. Another lesson I learned in 2017 is sometimes you have to block people in real life and on social media. And this is just like a big thing for me, like, because I'm the type of person, I like really care about the relationships I build with people. And also, I'm a Taurus, so I'm just naturally stubborn and bull. Like, I'm a bull. Like, stubborn, I'm a savage, and I'm gonna say what I want, and I don't care what you, if you like it or not. But I'm gonna only tell you once if you piss me off. The next time, it ain't gonna be so nice. Like, the first time, I might tell you real nicely. The second time, it ain't gonna be so nice. So, therefore, I just been learning to just not deal with people. I'm already not much of a people person. Like, I'm very antisocial. Like, a lot of people don't believe that. Like, I'm very antisocial. And a lot of the time, it comes up as mean. And I'm not mean. Like, I try not to be mean, really. But I'm just the type of person, like, I just say to myself. Like, I really do. Like, I have siblings, but I still always stay to myself. It's kind of weird, because you think, like, oh, you got siblings, you know, you would. No. I've just always been a loner all my life. For real, for real. Always been a loner. I have no problem being a loner. I don't have a lot of friends. And I just keep it that way. I would rather sit and do this all day, seriously, and watch YouTube videos. And I would be fine with just that. Nobody talking to me, I'd be good. But that's, you can't live life like that. But, you know, like, you can't allow people to press your buttons, like, constantly, and you constantly give them chances. So, just me, I just been learning to block people in real life and on social media. Once I stop dealing with you, period, yeah, that's it. Like, once I stop talking to you, you're a dead cause. Like, I seen something the other day, like, about how people be sneak dissing people who don't even give a fuck if they alive. That's pretty much the story of my life. Like, you could sneak diss me all you want. 9 times out of 10, I really don't care. If you, like, I don't care. I don't care about you. I don't care for you. So, yeah, that's just that. No shots or nothing. Just real speaking. And another lesson I learned in 2018 was to glow up and grow up. You cannot let things that hurt you hinder you. You at some point need to, you know, figure out a positive reinforcement for that. So, like, with me, I went through what I went through, but I took all of that and I put that into my brand, and I had tunnel vision on my brand. I had tunnel vision on getting better, tunnel vision on working with people who could make my brand better. So that actually helped me blowing up and growing up. Yes, I glowed up. I lost a little weight. You know, I didn't gain that weight back, but it's gonna come off. You know, it's holidays. You know, girl be eating, so y'all know how that goes. But yeah. So, what are your goals for 2018? Okay, I have several different goals. So, one of my goals for 2018 is to relaunch my fashion blog. As you guys know, I used to blog all the time, and I really enjoyed it, and I fell off. Like, I don't know how. So, I purposely had got my blog redone and everything for when I went off to school, so I can constantly be posting and things like that. But then when I got to school, it just stopped. And so, I haven't, like, blogged since then, and I've been trying to, like, get into, like, changing my website and buying my URL, and it's just a lot. So I just want to relaunch my blog and stick to my guns about posting, because especially when I go back to New York, like, there's no reason why I should not be posting, like, the fits I'm wearing to class and stuff. So yeah. Another goal is I would like to hit 1,000 plus subscribers. Right now I believe I'm close to 620, and that's not that far away from 1,000. I really want to hit 1,000. Like, it's just a goal. It don't, like, because once you kind of hit 1,000 subscribers on YouTube, like, you become like more known and brands know you and things like that, and that's something big to me. Like, and that's another thing I put on here, like, I want to begin to work with brands, not because I like free stuff, but I don't have a problem paying for anything. It's just that, like, I feel like, why shouldn't the next person put the next person on? Like, we all need help at some point, so I just love helping people. So that's why I want to work with brands. Yeah, like, why not? And you know me, I'm very honest. Like, I don't lie about anything, any products that I have or anything like that, you know. So yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I want to start going to more beauty and fashion events. I know that I'm working, but I plan to start taking off for this stuff if I know in advance, because that's the only way I'm going to get my brand out there. And yeah, another thing I want to do in 2018, sorry, that's why I don't like these Android phones. They lock too fast. Like, sis, I'm reading a list. Oh, okay, so this might be a dramatic goal, but I really need this to happen. Like, I want to meet Nicki Minaj in 2018. If that happens, I'm gonna die and come back to life again. All jokes aside, y'all know I live for Nicki. She's my favorite. I need to meet her. I was pissed because she had the Mac event and I could not go. But it's okay. Nicki, I want to meet you. Please. Just in the atmosphere, in the universe. I'm just throwing that out there, you know. It's gotta happen. Lastly, I want to start my handmade cosmetics brand in 2018. I tried to do it in 2017 over the summer. It really didn't work out. So that's definitely a goal. Lastly, what are you looking forward to in the new year of 2018? So the main thing that I am excited for in 2018 is that I am officially starting my new major at LIM College. I thought they were going to give me a hard time with switching. So basically, I am now, instead of being a fashion merchandising major with a concentration in styling, I am a fashion media major. If you guys want me to do a video on exactly what that is or etc., I will do so. Just let me know in the comments below or like this video. And yeah, I'm officially a fashion media major, and I'm excited because, like, some of the classes I'm taking are so dope. Like, I get to take a fashion photography class. I have, like, a lot of writing classes, but that's okay because I actually enjoy writing. I'm like a little nerd when it comes to English, honestly. But yeah, that's the thing that I'm most excited for in 2018, and just building my brand, honestly. Like, I couldn't ask for anything more. So yeah, that was about a year ago tag. I hope you guys enjoy. If you guys want to see more videos like this, or like me talking more and let y'all know a little more about my life, comment below. As always, comment, rate, and subscribe. I love you guys so much. Bye.